Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you all for the third session of BWE online class. Today I'll be starting unit number 4. Okay. So let us wait for some time, 1 or 2 minutes, so that all can join. I'll be starting fourth unit. Inform your friends, those who are unaware, please tell them. Most of the students will not see the messages. You please pass the message to your friends that come online for your BWE session has started. Everyone can see the video, no? I mean, for everyone it is visible, no? Paper, sheet. Again, same at the end of the video. Write your roll number along with the branch in the comment box so that we'll be getting the attendance. I hope everybody had your lunch. So we'll start. If stomach is full, your brains will start working. Otherwise, okay. Empty stomach, empty brain, full stomach, functional brain. So one by one, all are joining the group. Let us wait for 1 more minute. Okay, we'll start the session now. So we already completed 3 units. Yesterday we covered the problems also. So today we'll start fourth unit. Unit 4 is combination of DC machines and single phase induction motor. Okay. So this is the unit 4 content. It is combination of two topics. One is DC machines, another single phase induction motor. Again, DC machine is having two topics, subtopics. One is DC generator, another one is DC motor. Okay. So today we'll cover this portion. I'll be starting with DC machines first. Later on, we'll go for single phase induction motor. So I'll be starting DC machines. In DC machines, today we'll be dealing with DC generator. So we'll study about DC generator. In DC generator, we'll cover construction, we'll cover working principle, then we'll know what is EMF equation of DC generator. EMF equation we'll study, then we'll study types of DC generator. Then problems. Okay, so today we'll cover all these topics. This completes your DC generator. If you cover all these 5 points, it completes your DC generator. So today we'll study all these fundamentals. What is the construction of DC generator? How it works? If what is the amount of EMF equation we get inside the DC generator? Then how, what are the different types of DC generators we have? Then we'll do some problems. One or two problems we'll do. Then we'll finish this topic today. So before studying deep into DC generator, first of all, we'll understand what is generator. Okay, you already know, we did the experiments in the lab also. Generator means, what is generator? Generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy, which produces electricity, that is nothing but generator. This is in simple words. But technical definition of generator, generator is electrical device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. So mechanical energy into electrical energy it is converting means, which will be the input to the generator, which will be the output to the generator. Mechanical will be input and electrical will be output. Okay, so this is about the generator. Now we were studying a DC generator, and you already know electricity is divided into two types, AC and DC. The generator which works on DC supply is nothing but DC generator. Okay, this is generator which converts mechanical will be input and electrical will be output. So what is the working principle behind this? Working principle to convert this operation, which is making the device to convert mechanical to electrical, what is the working principle behind that? So that we need to discuss in this. Okay, so right now orally I will say that what is the working principle. Working principle of transformer is mutual induction. Working principle of induction motor is rotating magnetic field. Similarly, working principle of DC generator is Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. You already know what is Faraday's laws. Okay, if the conductor cuts the flux, flux will change and EMF will induce, right? So on this working principle your DC generator works. We'll be giving mechanical input and we'll be getting electrical output. What is the working principle is taking place in this? Faraday's laws. Using Faraday's laws, we are converting mechanical to electrical. Okay, right? So inside this generator, we should have conductor, we should have flux, and we should have relative motion. Then only we can able to apply Faraday's laws. So how we get the conductors, how we get the plugs, how we get the relative motion, those all will study in working principle. Before that, you should be cleared about what is its construction, right? So now DC generator is electrical device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy, and Faraday's law of electromagnetic principle is the working principle of DC generator. And at the time of explaining the transformer, I told you that change of flux takes place in two ways. One is static, another one is dynamic. And in transformer, static flux takes place. That is why there statically induced EMF induces. What is the condition for the static flux? Nothing should move. Either flux should not move or conductor will not move. Anything will not be moving there. Everything will be constant. Here it is not the case. This is dynamic flux. This is the case of dynamic flux. In dynamic flux, what is the definition of dynamic? Anyone will be rotating with respect to other. Either flux will be rotating, or conductor will be rotating. Anyone will be making it to rotate with respect to other. That is why it is dynamic kind of flux. So whatever the EMF induces, with this dynamic flux is nothing but dynamically induced EMF. Okay, here we'll be making conductors to move with respect to flux. Flux will be constant and will make the conductors to move. And in case of three phase, we did flux to rotate and conductors were constant, right? So here we'll be making conductors to move and flux will be constant, and whatever the amount of EMF induces, that will be dynamically induced EMF, because whatever the flux is changing, that is in dynamic nature. Okay, so today we'll see right now we'll see construction. What is the construction of DC motor generator? What is the constructional details of DC generator? What are the different parts it consists? Basically, DC generator is divided into two parts. Okay, generator is divided into two parts. One is, I'll be giving some gap, and after that I'll be writing why. I will tell you later on. It is divided into majorly two parts. One is stationary part, other one is rotational part. It is divided into two parts. Let us keep this as it is. First we'll draw the diagram. For drawing the diagram purpose, I left the space here. First we'll draw the diagram. Later I will tell you what are the why I have written this. You only will tell me the parts one by one. So this is construction of DC generator and drawing. So this simple diagram carries 2 marks. If you draw the diagram in the exam, only diagram if you draw and label the parts, you'll get 2 marks. This is the importance of diagrams of DC generator and motor both. So this is how we have to draw. So in this way we have to draw the diagram again. So inside this one more circle, and I'll be darkening this circle. Okay, so here 2 boxes will be there. Here also I'm darkening this. So what are these? This is how construction of DC motor looks like. So these 4 are called as poles. These are the poles. Okay, and this is called as pole shoe, and again it will be like this. So like this I am showing the windings. These are the windings. These are called as field windings. Okay, these are the field windings. This portion, this line is called, this complete part is called as poles. Poles will be having, this is pole shoe. From here to this portion is pole shoe, and this is pole core. Okay, and on the pole core you are seeing the windings, now they are called as field windings. Then next, these field windings are joined one another like this. This is also like this, this is also like this, and this is also like this. All the field windings will be joined to one another, and any two field windings will take outside like this. Any two field windings in this fashion will take outside, and here will be having phase and neutral. This is called as terminal box, or you can say extension box, or you can say switchboard. Usually you find switchboards in home, no? Like this. This is also switchboard, from where we take the supply by using wires. So this is called terminal box. And here at the bottom, this is base plate, or you can say stand also, on which DC machine is resting. Next, inside, this is one part you can see now. This is complete part is armature. This is called as armature. This complete part, inside this armature you are finding this spaces, you know, blocks. These are called as armature slots. Okay, inside these armature slots will be keeping armature conductors, small round circles. They are nothing but armature conductors. They are called as armature conductors. Next, after armature, again you are finding one more small circle. These are there, no? With number of lines. So this part is called as commutator. This is commutator. Okay. Next, one more is there inside. This part is shaft. Okay. Shaft will be like mechanical shaft will be like long rod will be there, iron rod. You normally see, no? If you see the fan, normal one rod will be there, no? On that rod only all the machines will be mounted, like rotor, motor, everything will be mounted on that rod, no? So that rod is nothing but shaft. Technical word is shaft. Okay, on that shaft only we will be mounting this commutator. This is commutator. Commutator will be mounted on this shaft. So we'll make the shaft to rotate. We'll give the mechanical input to the shaft only. We'll make the shaft to rotate. As shaft will rotate, or on the shaft commutator is mounted, that also starts rotating. In this way we give the mechanical input to the DC generator. Okay, you might have seen, to start the DC generator we'll be switching on the diesel engine. Petrol will put, no? Diesel will put, no? In the DC generator. Why we put the diesels? With the help of diesel, we'll start the engine. Engine will give the mechanical rotate, mechanical input to the generator. That is why we use diesel in the generators. When we start the generator, when we put the diesel, engine will start. That engine is nothing but mechanical input. That is called as prime mover also. Okay. In the olden days, diesel engines and all were not there. So, what we were doing, using man, we used to start the generator. One handle was to be there. Initially one handle will be one handle we were using the handle. So man will be rotating that handle. Once he starts that one, he once mechanical input is given, diesel starts and the generator starts working. In this way we give the mechanical inputs here. So nowadays those manpower is replaced with the prime movers, diesel engines, steam turbines and all we use. That is only to give the mechanical. So this is nothing but parts of the DC generator. One more important part we have missed here. This is yoke. This is called as yoke. Okay. This portion is yoke. Inside this, some thing will be rotating. What is this? Tell me what is this? Inside this, I have marked dotted lines. What is that? This is flux. Okay. This is called as flux. Inside this yoke, flux will be rotating. Likewise in transformer or in induction motor. So this is the construction part. So here this construction part I have divided into two categories. One is stationary category, another one is rotating category. So here what are the constant parts which will not move? Those all comes under stationary. The parts which will move throughout the process or the parts which move inside the DC generator, they are called as, they are considered as rotating parts, and the parts which are stationary throughout the process in the DC generator, they are nothing but stationary parts. Now by seeing the diagram, you can tell me what are the stationary parts and what are the rotationary parts. Stationary will be first terminal box is stationary, base plate is stationary. Okay, base plate is stationary. Then field windings are stationary, they will not move. Field windings, then poles also stationary, poles also will not move in the DC generator. Apart from this, did we miss any stationary part? Yoke, important part. Yoke is also stationary. Yoke, poles, field winding, base plate, these all will not move in the DC generator. Pole is nothing but, pole is divided into two types, pole core and pole shoe. Okay, so together I have written here as a pole. Next, tell me the rotationary parts, the parts which rotates inside the DC generator. First armature will rotate, then commutator also will rotate, then important part shaft is also rotating part. Okay, these all parts will rotate. Brushes will be constant, but it is attached to the, one more important, I forgot now, here these black holes, upper and lower, upper side and lower side, these are called as brushes. These are brushes. So from these brushes only will take the output. Across these brushes only, from these brushes only we connect the output. Across this only will take the electrical output from the brushes. One from here like this, from the brushes. This you should not mention in the exam, this part. This is for your understanding purpose I am showing here. From where we take the output in the generator, from where we give the input, from the terminal box to field windings we give the input, but output will be taken across the brushes. Okay, this is the procedure how we take the output and how we take the, how give the input, right? So here field windings are stationary, stationary parts are base plate, field windings, poles and yoke, these are the stationary parts. And rotating parts means armature, commutator, shaft, brushes. Brushes will not rotate, but brushes will be attached to the commutator. Commutator will be rotating now. So along with that, brushes also looks like rotating. That is why I considered brushes also in a rotating part. Don't get confused. Okay. These are the armature conductors. Inside this have shown the holes, you know, these are the armature conductors. Now let us discuss the function of each part and what is the make of each part. What is the function of each part and with which material each part is prepared. Okay. So first part we'll discuss. Before that, one more time I'll brush up. This is the constructional diagram of DC generator. It is divided into two categories, stationary and rotationary. The parts which are constant throughout the process in the DC generator are nothing but stationary parts. They are field winding, poles, yoke, base plate. These all are stationary parts. Then the parts which rotate in the DC machine, DC generator during the process are armature, commutator, shaft and brushes. These all are rotationary parts. Okay, one more time I am highlighting on field windings only. Across the field winding only we give the input in the DC generator, across the field winding from here. Okay, across the input is given to field winding only in the DC generators all the time, and output is taken across the brushes, right? So we are giving, sorry, not in, one more is a shaft. Shaft is to give the mechanical input. Okay, field winding, using field winding we are giving the electricity supply. For what is the purpose of giving that electricity supply along with the shaft, we'll understand once I explain the functions of each part. Okay, so here let us discuss each part function one by one for more clarity. First we'll discuss what is yoke. Okay, so see here, yoke is here, this part is yoke. So yoke is nothing but yoke is forming the outer layer of the DC generator. It forms the outer layer. So function of yoke is, it forms the outer layer, hence it acts as protecting device. It acts as protective device for the generator to protect it from the, it acts as the protective layer, you can say protective layer. It forms the outer layer, you can say it forms the protective layer which protects the generator from harmful atmospheric conditions. Okay, it acts as protective device which protects the generator from the harmful atmospheric conditions, like harmful atmospheric conditions like hot air, like heavy rain, you can say heavy rain, heat, moisture, okay, etc. So yoke basically here does the protection work. So it protects the device from the hazardous atmospheric conditions, like during heavy rain we have to protect it, during the overheat conditions we have to protect, then during moisture, then if any fire accident takes place, fire hazards also. So from these all atmospheric conditions, it will protect the DC generator, and it also forms the outer layer. This is first function. Second function, it provides the mechanical strength. It provides the mechanical strength. It provides the mechanical strength to poles. Okay, see here, on this both part is nothing but yoke only. On this yoke portion only we have kept the poles, so it is giving the mechanical support to the poles. On yoke only poles are resting. Okay, here, then here, here. So all poles are resting on the yoke only. So it also provides the, its function is to produce the mechanical strength to the poles. Now next question is, it is made up of which material? Yoke is made up of which material? It is, you already know, yoke is made up of, yes, it is made up of iron or steel. Okay, because its function is to carry the flux. See here, inside the yoke, what is flowing? Flux only flowing inside the yoke. Here, okay, right? So it provides path for the flux. So these are the different functions of yoke. Okay, first function is it forms the outer layer of the, it forms the outer layer of the DC generator, hence it acts as protective device and protects the generator from the harmful atmospheric conditions like heavy rain, heat, then fire hazards, then moisture. Then it provides the mechanical strength to the poles. It is made up of cast iron because it is used to conduct the, it is used to generate the magnetic flux. That is why it is made up of magnetic material, either iron or steel. Then next point is, you can make a note of it if you want. Okay, the next is poles. Okay, poles are divided into two types. There are two types of poles, is divided into two types. One is pole core, another one is pole shoe. Okay, pole core and pole shoe. This is pole core. This portion is, line is there, no? This line is called as pole core. And this horizontal structure is there, no? Like this. This portion. This portion is called as pole shoe. Okay. You can see the its structure. It is extended like this. So the why this extension shape, why this shape is given, means to get the large amount of flux induced in the pole. To get the more amount of flux induced, we have increased the shape of the pole in that fashion. Okay, so pole core, it is used to carry the field windings. Okay, it is used to carry the field windings. See here, on this pole core only we have made the windings, we have wounded the windings. So this complete portion is carrying the field windings. That is why its pole core function is to carry the field windings. It is again made up of, here function of poles also is to produce the flux only. Okay, so it is made up of again which material? Cast iron or steel. Pole core is also made up of iron or steel. Next, pole shoe. It is used to direct the flux produced by yoke towards armature. Okay, see, and what I have written, pole shoe is used to direct the flux produced by yoke towards the armature. Means whatever the flux is produced by poles and yoke inside the generator, it should flow towards the armature only. All the amount of flux should go through the armature only. So that will be provided by pole shoe here. See, whatever the flux is producing by this yoke and these poles, you know, all flux should go through armature part only. Okay, that will be done by pole shoe. That is why this structure is given to the poles. Extended structure is given. Why extended? Why this long structure is given? Because all the flux produced by this pole should go to armature only. Okay, this is the function of pole shoe. So it is used to direct the flux produced by the yoke towards the armature. It is also made up of iron because it is conducting flux only. So it is also made up of iron or steel. Okay, so this is about poles. Then next, pole core is over, poles over. Next is field windings. This is important. Now I will ask you one question. In the transformer, how we were inducing the EMF? First of all, to induce the EMF, we need three things: flux, conductor, and relative motion. Either flux has to rotate or conductor has to rotate. But in transformer, how we are inducing the EMF? We are making the flux to change and we are inducing the EMF. So here, which kind of flux is taking place? Dynamic. So in dynamic case means anyone we have to rotate. So in the beginning only I told, here we'll be making conductor to rotate. We are making the conductors to rotate. And how we are giving relative motion? We are giving the mechanical input to the shaft. We are rotating the shaft. As shaft rotates, along with that commutator rotates, and along with that armature also rotates, because commutator we kept inside the armature only. So as armature rotates, as shaft rotates, indirectly armature also rotates. Now rotation is given, conductors are also available. Now we need to have flux. How we are getting flux? Because until unless current is passed to the magnet, we cannot produce the flux. So how we are producing the flux here? So for to produce the flux, we need some amount of current. Okay, then only we can able to produce the flux. So that current is given by field winding. See here, these field windings are there, no? So to these field windings, using external supply, we are giving the current. Once these field windings get the currents, this pole is magnet. On this magnet, I have owned the copper windings. These field windings are made up of copper windings, right? So once I give the supply to the field windings, as they are owned on the magnetic materials, what happens? They becomes electromagnet. And what is the function of electromagnet? They produce the flux. So this is how we create the flux in the DC generator. This supply is given to produce the flux, and shaft we are rotating using the diesel engines. Mechanical rotation is given, this will rotate, and with the help of field windings we are producing the flux. This produces the flux. So this flux come in contact with rotating armatures. What happens? This flux will be cut by these armature conductors. EMF will induce inside the armature. Okay, remaining thing I'll tell you later on. Before that, understand what is field winding. So field winding is, it is used to carry necessary, it is used to carry necessary current required, it is used to carry necessary current required to produce flux. Okay, field winding is used to carry the minimum current which is required to produce the flux. So what is it? Is made up of what? It is made up of, it is used for carrying the current. So it is made up of copper. Okay, so it is made up of copper. It is also called as excitation winding. Field winding is also called as excitation winding because it excites the DC generator, right? Until unless you give the supply to the field winding, DC generator will not start. Okay, that is why it is called as excitation winding. It excites the machine. It is also called as excitation winding. So field winding is used to carry the current, necessary current which is required to produce the flux. Inside the degenerator we need flux. That flux will be produced by this field winding only. Okay, because by passing the current into field winding we are making the poles act as electromagnets. Once they act as electromagnets we can get the flux, right? Next, this is about field winding. So one more time I am stressing on field winding only because it is important part. Without field winding you cannot start the DC generator. Okay, that is why you can remember while doing the experiments in the labs, F1, F2, you were select giving the connections there. F1 to 1, 1 is to F1, another one is to F2. F1, F2 stands for field winding. So directly from the supply you were giving to F1 and F2, right? So F1 and F2 nothing but field winding. Until unless you give supply to field winding, machine will not run. Why will not run? Because there will not be any flux. If no flux means no cutting of flux. No cutting of flux means no EMF, right? Then next part, what is the next part? Field winding is over. Next is we'll study about armature. Okay, armature is again divided into two parts, armature core and armature winding. Armature core and armature winding. Armature core, it is used to carry the armature conductors. Okay, this is armature, no? So it is divided into the slots are nothing but armature core. Inside the slots I have kept conductors, no? So these slots are nothing but armature core. Inside this core only we have kept the windings, no? That is why it is acts as, it provides a path, or it is used to carry the armature conductors. You can also write this as it is house for armature conductors. You can also say that it is house for armature conductors. Armature conductors or windings, both are same, don't get confused. So armature core is used to carry the armature conductors, or it provides the house for the armature conductors. Inside the armature core only we keep the armature conductors. So this is also made up of magnetic material only, made up of iron or steel. Armature portion, armature core is made up of iron or steel. Next, armature windings or conductors. Its function is production of EMF or current takes place in armature windings or armature conductors only. Okay, right? EMF, it production of EMF takes place in armature conductors only. Now tell me, it is made up of which material? Armature conductors are made up of armature conductors are made up of, because I am telling you that production of EMF takes place in armature windings only. So it is made up of obviously current carrying material. So which conducts the current? Current is, it is conducting current. So it is made up of either copper or aluminium, right? So armature conductors are made up of copper, but armature core is made up of iron. Inside the armature core we keep the armature windings. So this production of EMF, whatever the EMF induces in the generator, that induces in the armature windings only. Okay, in the armature part only production of EMF takes place. It is made up of copper. This is about armature. Then next fifth point is commutator. Okay. Its function is to convert the alternating current to DC current, to convert AC to DC, because whatever the EMF we induces inside the generator, no, or inside the armature, it will be AC EMF only. Whatever the current we generate inside the armature is AC only. We generate always AC current. So to convert AC to DC, we need one device. That device is called as commutator. So function of commutator is to convert the alternating current to DC, direct current. One more, it is used to collect the current from armature. It is used to collect the current from the armature. Its function is to collect the current from the armature. Whatever the current induces in the armature, that current again passes to the commutator. Okay, whatever current is generating here will be AC. That AC current will go to the commutator. Conversion of AC into DC happens inside the commutator only. So this is the function of commutator. We always generate AC, that is converted into DC using this device commutator. So it serves for the two purposes. One is, it is used to collect the current from the armature and give it to convert that current into DC current. This is the function of the commutator. So commutator is made up of, again, what? It is conducting current only. It is for current carrying purpose. So it is made up of, again, yes, it is made up of, again, copper only, right? So it is also made up of copper, right? Next important and last part, brushes. What is the function of brushes? Brushes you can find here. What is the function of brushes? I told at the beginning, across the brushes only will take the output. So your output current will be which current? DC current, right? So function of brushes is, first function of brushes is, it is used to collect the, it is used to collect the current from commutator. It used to collect the current from the commutator and make it available to the what? And make it available to the external circuit. And make it available to the external circuit. This is the function of the brush. This is the function of the brush. It is used to collect the current from the commutator. Whatever the current converted in commutator, which current will be available in the commutator? DC current. It collects the DC current from the commutator and it will give to the external circuit. See here. From the commutator, it will collect the current. From the commutator, it will collect the current and it will give back to the external circuit like this. Okay. So this is the function of the brushes. So it is made up of, brushes are made up of soft material. Brushes will be very soft. They are made up of either carbon or mica. Okay. Sorry, carbon. This is made up of carbon material. Brushes are made up of carbon. Right. So these are the functions of each part. So one by one we'll again brush up. First, By seeing the diagram, I will tell you. This is the construction of DC machine, DC generator. One important thing you have to remember here. DC machine is divided into two types, motor and generator. Construction of both motor and generator is same. This DC motor construction is also same only. Construction details of both motor and generator is same. Only working principle changes. Okay. If anybody asks you to draw the construction of DC motor, means same diagram you have to draw, because construction of DC motor and generator is same. Only working principle changes. So construction of DC generator is divided into two categories, stationary and rotational. The parts which are stationary throughout the process comes under stationary part, and the parts which rotates comes under rotational part. Field winding, yoke, poles, base plate, these all are stationary parts. Armature, commutator, shaft, brushes are rotational parts. The function of yoke is, yoke forms the outer layer and it acts as protective device for the circuit, protective device for the device, and it protects the machine from the atmospheric conditions like heavy rain, overheat, then moisture, fire, accidents. Now from these all conditions, yoke will protect the device, and it provides the mechanical strength to the poles. Yoke provides the mechanical strength to the poles, poles resting on yoke only. Okay, and it also provides the path for the flux to flow through inside the machine. Then next, poles. Poles are used for producing the fluxes. Poles are made up of magnetic materials. All poles are made up of magnetic materials. Their function is to produce the flux only. How they will produce the flux? With the help of the field winding. Until unless you give the supply, poles will not produce the flux. So they are nothing but electromagnets. Electromagnets produce the flux only when they get the current to pass through. Okay, so current is made available from the external supply, will pass the current to the field windings. Once we get the, when we pass the current to field windings, poles becomes electromagnet and they produce the flux. Okay, next, field winding. It is also called as excitation winding. It is used to carry the current which is required to produce the flux. To produce the flux, we need some current. That current is given by field windings only. So field winding is made up of copper material. Then next, rotating parts. Rotating part, armature. It consists of armature, commutator, shaft, brushes. Armature, this portion is armature. It is made up of, armature is made up of iron material or steel material. It is consisting of two parts, armature slots, then armature conductors. Armature slots are used to carry the armature conductors, and armature conductors are the one where EMF induces. Okay, so this is made up of, this armature conductors are made up of copper material because they are used to carry the current. Okay, so once this flux interacts with this armature conductors, this armature, cutting of flux takes place, and that cutting of flux, due to cutting of flux, EMF induces. That EMF will induce in this side these armature conductors. Okay, that is a production of EMF takes place in armature portion only. This is the armature. Production of EMF takes place in armature portion only. Next, commutator. After the armature, we have commutator. So commutators is used to convert the AC current produced inside the armature to DC current. So here function of commutator is to convert the AC current to DC current. It is made up of copper only. Then next comes brushes. Function of brushes is to collect the current, converted DC current from the commutator and give it to external circuit. Okay, through brushes only we take the output in the DC generator. Okay, then shaft is already told you. Shaft is the pole, mechanical rod you can say. On that pole only all these armature, commutator are rested, right? This commutator that is made up of iron material only. Pole is made of iron material. Rod will be like iron rods only, right? So on this shaft only we fix the, we mount the commutator, then we mount the armature. because army commutator will be kept inside the armature. The complete setup is mounted on the shaft, and to the shaft only we give the mechanical input, or on the shaft we connect the diesel engines and all. Yes, it is used to rotate the armature, you can say. It is used to rotate the armature, you can say, in easy words. Okay, shaft is used to rotate the armature. Rotating the armature means we are giving the mechanical input, right? Because generator, to the generator we give mechanical input. So that input is given through the shaft only. Okay, now come to working principle. I'll tell you working principle, what happens. Simple sentences. So here for your more clarification, this is shaft. It will be like this. On the shaft we'll be having armature. This you can say armature. So inside the armature only we'll be having commutator also, right? So this is how we mount the armature on the shaft, and here we'll be having field windings. This you can say field windings, and across this will be taking output. These are, you can say, brushes. So across this will be connecting load. We can connect anything, fan, sorry, you can connect anything, you can connect refrigerator. Okay, load. So what we are doing, keep, what is the working principle of DC generator? It works on Faraday's laws. Observe here carefully. Faraday's laws. For the Faraday, in the Faraday's laws, to induce the EMF, we need flux. We need conductor. And we need relative motion. So these three things we require. Then only we induce EMF. Now observe carefully. We need conductor. Conductor is given by armatures, because armature is having conductors, right? Armature consists of conductors. This is armature. Armature consists of conductors. So conductor V is there. Then we need relative motion. So what we are doing, using prime movers. Using prime movers, we are rotating this shaft. We are making the shaft to rotate. We are giving the mechanical input. Using prime movers, we are making the shaft to rotate. So we have created relative motion. As shaft rotates, whatever the things mounted on the shaft, armature, they also rotates. Don't get confused. This will not rotate. For your understanding purpose, I have shown this field winding, right? So armature rotates. So inside the armature we have conductors, armature conductors also rotates. So this is how we create the relative motion. We have conductors, we have relative motion. Now next thing is we need to have flux. So that flux is created in the generator with the help of field winding, because we give the supply to the field winding, some external supply we are giving using power supply. Externally we are giving the input to the field winding. Once we give the input to the field winding like this, okay, what happens? Current passes through the poles. Poles are magnetic materials. Once we pass the current to this, these poles produces flux because they become electromagnets. In this way we are producing the flux. Now we have all the three quantities which are required to produce the EMF. We have flux now, we have inductor now, we have relative motion also. Relative motion is given by mechanical input. Conductors are also available in the already available in the construction. Flux we are creating with the help of external supply to the field winding. Okay, until unless we have field winding, we cannot produce the flux. If we cannot produce the flux, we cannot create the EMF. If we cannot create the EMF, we cannot take the output across the generator. So DC machine will not work until unless we give the supply to field winding. So after giving the supply, field winding produces the flux. field winding produces the flux. This field winding produces the flux. This flux, all these four flux, in this way it will create the flux. Okay. So this complete flux will, it tries to pass through the armature conductors. Once flux is produced with this armature conductor to rotate. Okay. These armature will be rotating. While rotating, this armature comes in contact with these fluxes. So what happens? Cutting of the flux takes place. Once flux cut by the conductor, what happens? According to Faraday's law, EMF induces. So this EMF is of AC. Whatever the EMF we induces inside this armature, this will be AC armature. Also AC EMF. This AC EMF will pass into this commutator. This AC will go through this commutator, and conversion of AC into DC takes place inside this commutator. Okay. Then that converted DC current across the brushes, through the brushes, come out of the machine and make it available to the external circuit. This is how we produce the EMF inside the DC generator. Okay, we pass the current to the field winding, which produces the flux inside the generator, and we give the mechanical support, mechanical input to the armature through the shaft. As shaft starts rotating, armature also starts rotating, and hence armature conductors, and flux produced by the poles will cut by the armature conductors, and EMF induces inside the armature. Whatever the EMF induces inside the armature will be of AC, that will be converted into DC by the device called commutator, and that converted DC current through the brushes we take out and connect across the load. So this is the construction working principle of DC generator. Okay, now this is how it is. We'll make the shaft rotate and we'll give the field winding, supply through the field winding. It produces the flux. That flux will come in contact with this armature conductors. These armature conductors cut the flux, and EMF induces. That EMF converted into DC in the commutator, and through the brushes, that will give you outside the load. Okay. So here one important thing we have to observe. We are inducing the EMF inside the commutator, inside the machine. In which direction that EMF is flowing, that will be given by Fleming's right hand rule. This is I already told you in the class only, in the very very beginning. Fleming's right hand rule. So Fleming's right hand rule is used to identify the direction of the EMF induced in the generator, right? So direction of EMF induced is given by Fleming's right hand rule. Next, EMF equation of the DC generator. EMF equation of DC generator. It is important derivation. For 3 marks, they will ask. EMF equation of DC generator. Now tell me, what are the various quantities which are responsible for producing the EMF in the generator? Okay. Conductors are very responsible for producing the EMF. Flux is responsible for producing the EMF. Then current. Then frequency. So these all are variable quantities which are responsible for producing the EMF. First, we'll write flux. Flux produced by conductor, important, right? This is first one. Then next, conductors. Conductors are denoted with the symbol Z. Okay, Z denotes the number of conductors. So Z is nothing but number of conductors. More amount of conductors, more amount of flux. More amount of flux means more amount of EMF, right? Next, speed. If conductor is cutting the flux means it should have speed, no? Until unless conductor rotates, flux will not be cut by the conductor. So for the rotation we need speed, no? So how much speed conductors are rotating, that also important. So speed of the conductor, what is the unit of speed? I told you in the lab, speed of the conductor in RPM, number of turns, that is different. Here n denotes speed of the armature conductors, right? Next, how you are producing the flux? Using the poles. Until unless you have poles, you will not produce the flux. So P means number of poles. Number of poles in the machine. Number of poles in the machine. Then next, EG. How much amount of voltage you are generating? Generated. So one more important thing we have to use here, that is A stands for number of parallel paths. Okay, don't get confused, what is this A parallel paths? Okay, no need to take tension, more tension about this. Only you have to understand that A means number of parallel paths, right? So these are the different quantities which are responsible producing the EMF inside the DC machine. Now let us derive the EMF equation with the help of all this one by one. Before that, you just want to make a note, you can make a note of it. These are the variable quantities. So we'll take only one revolution as a reference. With respect to one revolution of the conductor, we'll derive this. What happens if conductor makes one revolution? To cut the conductor, we need to cut the flux, we need the conductor to rotate. If conductor is making the rotation, means you can say that revolutions. In one revolution, conductor will cut the flux. How much amount of flux will be cut by conductor? We'll see. Magnetic flux cut by conductor in one revolution. If conductor makes one revolution, how much amount of flux is cutting by the conductor? That is given by, this is the change in flux. If flux is cutting means change of flux takes place, okay, right? D phi, this amount of flux is changing in one revolution. So what are the things we require to change the flux? We require flux and poles. If poles are there, then only it produce the flux, okay? Then only flux will change. So D phi is nothing but phi into P. So this amount of flux is changing. Now what is the time required to change the flux? Time required to change the flux in one revolution, tell me how much time is required to tell me how much time you require to change the flux in 1 second. Speed is measured in RPM, right? So for n revolutions, RPM means what? Revolutions per minute. For n revolutions, how many seconds you require? 60 seconds. Because in 1 minute, 60 seconds will be there. Now tell me, for one revolution, we are taking one revolution into consideration. For one revolution, how much time we require for one revolution? 1 will go to numerator, n will come to denominator, 1 by n into 60. So how much time we require? 60 by n seconds we require. So this is the time required to make one revolution. For n revolutions, 60 seconds. For one revolution, 60 by n seconds. So therefore, dt will be equal to 60 by n seconds. So this is the change in flux, equation number 1. This is equation number 2. Next, what we need? So average EMF induced. Average EMF induced per revolution is how much? T5 by rate of change of flux with respect to time. This we already know. Therefore, D5 is how much? From the equation 1, what is D5? D into pi. So D5 is phi into P. What is DT? It is 60 by n, right? So this is 60 by n, which can also be written as phi n p divided by 60. So E is equal to phi n p divided by 60. This is with one revolution and with respect to only one conductor. But there are z number of conductors. There are z number of conductors and a number of parallel paths. So if there are z number of conductors kept in a parallel paths, then E is equal to generator voltage phi np divided 60 into z number of conductors kept in a number of factors. So this is the EMF equation. Okay, question number 2, this is the EMF equation of DC generator. Again, in DC generators we have two types of windings. One is lap winding, another one is wave winding. So for lap winding we have to keep A is equal to P, and for wave winding we have to keep A is equal to 2 in the EMF equations. So for lap winding, EMF equation will be phi n p z divided by A is equal to P. So 60 p, this p get cancels. What is the equation remains? Phi z n divided by 60. This is the EMF equation for lap winding. Then for wave winding, we have to substitute A value as 2 and we have to write the EMF equation. So Eg is equal to phi n z p divided by 120. So this is the EMF equation for wave winding and this is the EMF equation for lap winding. If you remember this, you can write the EMF equation for lap and wave by knowing these conditions. Okay, for lap winding A will be P and for wave winding A will be 2, right? So we covered construction, we covered working principle, we covered EMF equations, right? Then next, types of DC generators are there and problems are there. Eg is what? Voltage, no? Voltage unit is what? Volt only. तो टाइप्स ऑफ डीसी जनरेटर, दिस आई विल कवर यू, दिस आई विल कवर इन नेक्स्ट सेशन बिकॉज टाइम इज ऑलरेडी ओवर, हार्डली 5 मिनट्स इज देयर, इन 5 मिनट्स वी कैनॉट कवर दिस टॉपिक, टू कवर दिस वी नीड मिनिमम हाफ एन आवर, ओके, दैट आई विल कंटिन्यू इन नेक्स्ट सेशन फ्रॉम टाइप्स ऑफ, आई विल कंटिन्यू नेक्स्ट सेशन विद टाइप्स ऑफ डीसी जनरेटर ओनली, ओके, सो एज ऑफ नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड वाट इज डीसी मशीन, वाट इज डीसी मशीन, डीसी मशीन इज कन्वर्टेड क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप, वाट इज इस कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल, वाट इज द इवेंट ईएमएफ इक्वेशन. Now don't forget to mention your rule number along with the branch in the comment section. Once again, don't do multiple entries. So thanks for joining me in the video lecture class. I'll be signing off. So bye, take care, study well. We'll see on 20 tomorrow. We'll see on 26 tomorrow. No class is there. We'll see on 26 same time, 1:32, 3 p.m. Okay, bye.